bad timing.
Yeah, it is bad timing.
What do you want, Sonny?
I want to discuss deception.
Laura doesn't want to discuss it, so why don't you just get lost?
You're a little too late. Carly and I have reached an agreement.
You and Carly aren't exactly friends. You don't think the truce will last.
I guess that's my problem.
I'm an interested party.
Well, not now. This is not the right time.
You know, I'm beginning to understand the motive behind your offer.
What offer?
Listen, you want to sell your share of deception? Call my office and we'll make a deal tomorrow.
It's Laura's company. I'll deal with her. Name your price. I'll buy you out, Laura.
What's going on?
I thought I'd come down to an old haunt with a new friend. Gia.
We've met.
Oh. So you know, she's a model. Although the whole deception thing might not work out, so I just came down to see how she was doing.
No, you didn't.
Oh, okay. Listen, can we talk about this tomorrow? Do you mind?
You bet I do. You were about to tell me something really important, and then Motorcycle Boy here showed up. Why don't you tell him to leave, Carly? I mean, I'm sure Elizabeth is waiting for him somewhere.
I said I would call you tomorrow.
First you double-crossed me, and now you're trying to dump me?
Okay. You're not my boyfriend. I said I would call you. Right now, my best friend seems to have a problem, and he comes first, so... Why don't you get yourself a beer, and we'll play pool?
Not until you stop lying.
I need to be alone with Jason now, so we'll talk about deception tomorrow.
Carly, no, look, I took a chance. I did exactly what you asked.
Excuse me, that is enough.
Oh, don't worry. I won't go around telling everyone our private business. No, unlike you, I keep my promises, but I am not going to stand by and watch Elizabeth steal my dream job, okay? I will be the face of deception with or without your help.
Okay, so, game of pool. You want to lag for the break and the usual rules? You win, I give you $20. I win, you dance.
What does she mean about Elizabeth?
Elizabeth and Gia are up for the same job, which Gia should get, but Elizabeth is going to because Laura plays favorites, and that's the end of the story.
So how'd you double-cross Gia?
Why do you care?
You were lying like crazy. That's fine, Carly. It's what you do. Just don't start on Elizabeth.
You know what? I knew it. I knew that she would go to you. She would run to you, crying. Big bad me. You know, Jason, you don't see this? She's using you.
People told me you were doing the same thing. Did I listen? No, because we were friends, the same as Elizabeth
okay,
is.
Okay, well, I haven't done anything to her. It's Laura and it's Lucky, and they're pushing her to do something that she doesn't want to do. I mean, Elizabeth knows. She's not a model.
You're missing the point. Leave Elizabeth alone.
You're in deep with her, aren't you? It's written all over your face.
I'm not selling. Carly and I have agreed to work together.
And what do you think the odds of that are, realistically?
I'll keep you posted.
She's not selling, so go launder your dirty socks someplace else.
Haven't you wasted enough of my time today?
What are you talking about? You're the one who came to see us.
Yeah, so come on. Take a walk. Get out of here.
You know something? I want to make something perfectly clear to you, Sonny. I'm not selling. Not now, not ever.
I'm willing to pay you enough so you can start your own business your own way.
No. No, I have worked like a dog for the past few months to make deception a success, and no, I'm not going to leave it now.
How can it be successful? You and Carly can't even agree on the face of deception.
Yeah, well, thanks to your wife.
She agreed today.
Oh.
Yeah. Mm. So, if she continues to show up to work, you know, willing to collaborate, I think that I probably can work with her. If she disappears for days at a time, then I will be forced to make some decisions for her. And yeah, I guess we probably will fight about it again. But you know what? Either way, I'm not selling.
Yeah, so get out of here, all right? I'm sure your goon is out there missing you.
Scotty, you come to my home uninvited to open up negotiations for the sale of deception. I'm just trying to follow through. I'm just trying to make it easy for you.
Now, how would that be? By forcing her out of her own company?
When you wanted to buy deception, you came to me for help.
And what did you do? You double-crossed her.
I made my conditions clear.
You wanted to create a job for your wife, and I accepted that. But she wants to phone in the decisions while I show up at the office every day and do all the work. Okay? So my problem is with her, not the company.
So why don't you grab your goon and go have a couple of
okay, you know what? Okay? Hold on here. I'm confused. Last night you come to my home and you tell Carly you can't stand working with her. You want to dissolve the partnership. Right? Today you send over Scotty with a $5 million offer to buy me out. Now, you know what? I don't know where you're getting that kind of cash, Laura. It's not really my business.
No, it isn't.
But if you want out, I'm just making a counter offer.
Yeah, I understand.
Unless Scott was acting without your knowledge. You did know about the offer, didn't you, Laura?
You know, Elizabeth is not right for you. She'll come and she'll cry on your shoulder and she'll let you, you know, drive the motorcycle and take her for a ride. She'll wrap her arms around your waist and wind in the hair and everything. But ultimately, she's just a tease. I mean, she'll go back to Lucky. I think that she likes being around you because you represent a walk on the wild side to her without any real danger. She knows that nothing would ever happen to her when she's with you. But in the end, once you've served your purpose, she'll dump you.
Are you finished?
No, I'm not. And I know that you don't want to hear this. But I know that you have this thing for these sort of virginal cheerleader types, but Elizabeth is just not right for you.
Just leave her alone, Carl.
If I had it my way, I'd never see her again. I didn't bring her into my life. Laura's the one who thinks that she's perfect for the face of deception. Personally, I think she's perfect for the face of Kelly's. Let her wipe down tables and bake brownies.
Why is this modeling thing so important to you?
Because if we go with Elizabeth as our signature model, we're going to be filing for Chapter 11, and I will look like a huge failure to everybody.
Carly, what do you care what anyone else thinks? And you have a home. You have a family. You have people who love you.
I know. Sonny and Michael, they've given me more than I could ever have imagined. But I need to prove that I can have a successful career.
Is it worth what you're doing?
I can have what I want. I can do it.
You always say that.
Well, I can, Jason. I mean, I can make this work. I can do this. I can make it. What about you?
I'm fine.
No, you're not. I screwed up, you know, ever since I slept with Sonny.
Carly, please just let it go.
No, I can't let it go. You know why? That is the time, that is the exact time in your life when Elizabeth wormed her way in. She got right in there. And I'm sorry,
What is your problem? If you can't have me, nobody can?
I am not trying to hold on to you for myself. I mean, I love Sonny. Why
okay, then.
Would I?
Back off.
Well, I want you to fall in love with somebody, you know, who deserves you. Somebody who will love you for the rest of your life. That's all. And as your friend, I'm telling you that Elizabeth is not that person.
You and Sonny chose each other. I accept that. Now you have to let me make my own choices.
Well, I want you to have what Sonny and I have. You know what? I thank God every day that I found him. And it may not have started out perfect, and I hurt you that night, I know. And I'm sorry.
Carly,
I'll always regret
it's
that.
It's over.
It's not over, you know? Elizabeth never lets me forget it. She just sticks that knife in there and twists it. You know, she's always giving me attitude ever since that night.
It's all in your head.
No, it's not in my head. Okay, I know. Ever since she found you and she became your friend and she took care of you, she's like your perfect little angel and somebody you won't hear a word against.
This has nothing to do with you.
It's because of me and what I did. I'm afraid for you. I know that she will hurt you. I mean, if you let her, if you fall in love, she'll break your heart.
Scotty would never go behind my back. He's my lawyer. We work together. He encourages me to make my own decisions.
That's good. But I'm still not selling.
Neither am I.
All right, well, I wish you all the best, and I hope that you and Carly can find a way to work together.
I am trying. And you know what? I think that she may be, finally. I think that Carly is very lucky to have someone like you who believes in her. I just hope that you don't end up disappointed one day.
Well, I'm not worried. Okay, I'll leave you and your lawyer to discuss whatever it is that you need to discuss. Getting your story straight, whatever. Okay. Good night.
Good night. You lied to me? Why?
I'm your lawyer, you know, and I'm your friend.
But you know what? You betrayed me, really, on both counts. How could you do that?
Sonny!
I told you he wouldn't be here.
I'll wait.
Jason, come on. I promised you that you could go and get on with your life, so don't hang out here with me. Get out there. Mingle.
I'm not leaving.
Why? The PC grill's full of hot babes.
I need to ask Sonny a favor.
What do you need?
You get Carly to back off Elizabeth?
Ah!
Carly?
What?
You making trouble?
You know what? You stay out of this. This is deception business, and you promise, so it's off limits.
I'll do what I can, Jason.
Hello?
Hmm.
Remember me? The person you promised to love, honor, cherish, respect?
You know something, Jason? You're the second person to show up here complaining how Carly does business.
I gave her a ride home from Jake's.
Right.
I just thought I'd mention it. Elizabeth doesn't need the grief, but Carly does not listen to me.
I heard you. Thank you. Goodbye.
Jason, you can stay as long as you want.
That's all right. I'm going.
Thanks for the support. What are you doing? I'm trying to save Jason here, you know? I'm trying to keep him safe so that little witch doesn't break his heart.
Can you answer one thing? Why do you care who Jason dates?
Look, I always care about the women in Jason's life because I want him to be happy. That's all.
He looks fine to me,
well,
Carly.
Well, he's not. You know
no?
what? Elizabeth will make him miserable, and we're his best friends.
Right.
We should try to help him, not sit back and buy front row tickets to watch him, you know, crash and burn.
You want to be Jason's friend?
Yeah.
Do what he wants and back off.
Elizabeth is deception business. You leave it to me.
I gave deception to you. I can take it away just
You said fast. That you would let me try.
And you said you would compromise with Laura. How does badgering Elizabeth fit into this?
First of all, Jason is so overreacting.
Oh, see, you're lying. And if you keep doing this with Laura, it's not going to work out. I got you into this. I can get you out. It's time to get you out.
I don't want to sell deception.
It's been a nightmare from day one. I've heard nothing but listen how you can't agree with anything with Laura.
I know, but we've come to a new place. You know, we've made a truce. We're starting a brand new thing.
We can still sell our half. Get you another business. Create our own thing.
I don't want that. I don't want to get out of deception until it's a huge success. I mean, I want to do this right, Sonny. I want you to believe in me.
Then stick to the rules.
Okay.
Okay?
No more trouble. I promise.